So good afternoon to all students, and today we are going to see the modes of formation of subject. So modes of formation of subject, in this there are various modes of formation of subject. So in this we are going to see the different modes of formation of subject, and here you can we are going to see the introduction. So whenever a new specific subject is developed, we have to give the helpful place among the already existing specific subject without disturbing the helpful sequence which is already arrived at. So whatever already the classificationist have done, the various subject classification, okay, already the sequence is decided. Okay, so now the problem is whenever we have whenever any specific subject is developed, then without disturbing the previous sequence, we have to give the place in the classification. Okay, so how we have to give the place, and for that classificationist have to understand the various modes of formation of subject, and the, even the classifier also have to understand how the formation of subjects are there. So there in Dr. S. R. Ranganathan, who is the father of library and information science, he has developed the modes of formation of subject only in the first time in 1944. Okay, so in 1944 in library classification, fundamental and procedure, he has identified some of the modes of formation of subject. There are three identification he has done, that is denudation, second one is lamination, and third one is loose assemblage. Okay, so previously in 1944, when Dr. S. R. Ranganathan has developed these three modes of formation of subject, after that decades, which means one decade, he has also added the two more modes. Okay, so that is dissection and the denudation. So altogether, it will be the five modes. Okay, so that is called as a five preliminary modes of formation of subject. Okay, and then a few modes of formation of subject has been also added, and that are altogether there are 12 modes of formation of subjects are there. So all these 12 modes of formation of subject, like other has means added, that is dissection, lamination, denudation, loose assemblage, and superimposition. And there are 12 modes of formation of subject, that is the lamination, and in lamination, one lamination is there, lamination one, that is called lamination two is there, third one is loose assemblage. Loose assemblage 1, loose assemblage 2, loose assemblage 3, and we have other modes. Fission is there, dissection is there, denudation, fusion, distillation, partial comprehension, and subject bundle. And after Dr. S. R. Ranganathan has developed these 12 modes of formation of subject, but after that, Dr. This M. A. Gopinath sir and Professor Sita Rama sir has redesignated this partial comprehension as an agglomeration. He has given the name as an agglomeration and the subject bundle as a cluster. Okay, so let us see one by one what is this lamination one. So in this mode, one or more isolate facets are laminated over a basic facet, and the result will be the compound subject. Now you will be slowly learning what is the subject. Okay, we have previously also seen that what is the subject. So here there are three types of subject. First is the basic subject, second compound subject, and the complex subject. So what happened in this particular modes, because basic subjects are laminated over a basic facet, means more isolates ideas or facet are laminated over a basic facet. So here we can take one example, that is library science in India. So library science in India, here the isolate facet is India. So India is a isolate facet, and which is laminated over the basic facet. So what will be the basic facet? This is the library science. So this is the basic facet. This is the basic subject, we can say. And India is the basic means isolate ideas or isolate facet. So here you can see that the India is laminated over a basic facet, that is library science. Okay. So here we can call it as a lamination one. Okay. Lamination one. The second thing, lamination two. Lamination two, what happened in this mode? Two or more facet of compound facet are laminated over one another. So here we can take the example child medicine in Ayurveda. So here in child medicine in Ayurveda, you can see that this is the child medicine in Ayurveda. The basic subject is medicine. Okay. But in medicine also, there are many facets. Like for example, we have a child medicine, we have a adult medicine also. Okay. So here the child medicine. So medicine M will be the main subject or main class. We can say it is a main class. So here main class is the medicine, and again child we are taking one facet. Within medicine there are different type of medicine according to the age will be suitable. So child we are taking only. So here the child is the more sub facet. Okay, so when we can say that more sub facet, it will form the compound facet or compound subject. Okay, so here the child medicine means child in medicine in Ayurveda. Even you can say that medicine is having the different according to different patterns, like Ayurveda is there, allopathy is there, homeopathy is there. So we are taking only the Ayurveda. So here the more facets are there. How the more facet will be there? You can see this will be the medicine. In medicine we have a different type of facet, like you can say that homeopathy is there, then allopathy is there, then Ayurveda is there. Okay, so here this is the one subject, and within one subject there are different facets, and there are different facet. And here also in medicine, according to the age if we are taking, then means we need a medicine for the children, medicine we need a different, and for adult we need a different medicine. So here the again if we take the age, so again we are taking the facet. So here also in the second stage we are taking the facet, and here also in the second stage we are taking a one facet, that is Ayurveda, and here we are taking the child. So two facet. Okay, in this mode, two or more facets of compound facets are laminated over one another, and that's why it is called as a lamination two. Okay, and the result will be we are getting the compound subject. Okay, so we have seen that basic subject is coming under lamination one, and compound subject you can see that the two more facets are laminated over a compound facet over one another. Okay, and that's why it is called as a lamination two. Then loose assemblage. What is loose assemblage? Loose assemblage means assembling together of two or more subjects. So it may be the basic subject or it may be the compound subject, and isolate idea in one and the same facet or array. So here we can take one example, that is the textbook of physics and chemistry. So here the physics is the main subject, and the chemistry is the main subject. So it will come to the main class of the science. So physics and chemistry. So but the textbook is there, and textbook which contain physics also and the chemistry also. So here you can say that this is a loose assemblage. Loose assemblage means between the two subject or between the two facets, we have a different type of relation. So relation may be like general relation we have in the, within the subject. We have also a bias relation. Comparison type of relation is like comparison between the physics and the chemistry. Then difference between the physics and chemistry. We have generally the relation of influence type of relation is also there. And one subject may be used as a tool also. So we have a different kind of relation. It may be the bias, it may be the general one, it may be the difference one, it may be the comparison one, or it may be the influence one, or we can use the tool, one subject as a tool for the another subject. For example, a library, statistics for library and information science. So statistics will be used as a tool for library and information science. So based on that, loose assemblage, one is there, two is there, and three is there. Okay. So what happened in one? Because in loose assemblage, there are assembling together or two or more subject. Okay. So here, what happened in loose assemblage one means relation between the physics and chemistry. So physics and chemistry is the different subject, and we are making the result, and the result is that we formed a compound subject, complex subject. So complex subject will be there when we form the loose assemblage. So here the relationship between the two subject and relation may be general one, like you can say that this is a textbook only. So this is the general relation, but we compare like comparison between physics and chemistry. So that will be the comparison type of relation. So like this is type of relation we have in the subject. So when it is the relation in between the two subject, then it is called as a loose assemblage. Okay. So relation between physics and chemistry, or it may be the general relation, or it may be the biased relation. Okay. Then what is loose assemblage two? Loose assemblage two, in this mode, two or more isolates taken from one and the same schedule are brought into mutual relation. Now here you can see that the example, comparative study of Jainism and Buddhism. So Jainism and Buddhism is coming under the religion. Okay, it is coming under religion. So Jainism and Buddhism is taken from only one schedule. So the main class is religion. Okay, so here the main subject and the main class is religion. So here you are taking from the only one subject, like you can say that this is the religion, and the part of religion is Jainism and the Buddhism. Okay, so this Jainism and Buddhism is coming here, and that's why from one schedule, from one subject only we are taking. So that is called as a loose assemblage two. So the relation between the Jainism and Buddhism, comparative type of relationship, relation is also there, or different type, differentiate or influence type of relationship is also there. So relation may be according to the six types that we have seen. So when we are taking the isolate from one schedule, and we are keeping the relation, mutual relation within the subject, then it is called as a loose assemblage one. So by this figure, you can understand it. Only one subject will be there, and within that subject, the facets or isolates are there, and in between we are framing the relation. We are it may be the comparative, it may be the comparative means differentiate, it may be the influence, or it may be the general type of relation, or it may be the biased type of relation. So that is called as a loose assemblage two. Then we have loose assemblage three. What happened in this loose assembly 3, in this mode, two or more isolate taken from one and the same array. Now you have to understand here the array. Array is a new word for you. So array of order higher than one in one and the same schedule are brought into mutual relation. Now we can understand what is meant by array. So here one subject will be there or one facet will be there, and within that subject we have a different, like for example, we have a library and information science. Here we have a different type of concept like management, then classification, then cataloging. Okay, so here we are taking the relationship between the UDC and the DDC. In classification, we have a different type of library classification schemes. So library classification schemes, in library classification scheme, we have a different type of schemes. Like we have a UDC, we have a DDC also, we have a LC, and okay, CC is also there. LC is there, Library of Congress classification scheme. CC is also there, and other type of schemes are also there. So here, just I want to give what is array. So array here, when one facet is again divided into the sub facets with the same, that is called as a collateral class. Okay, so the same class is there. Like in library science, we have a management, classification, cataloging, library automation, IT. So everything we have in the library science. Within that facet, like classification, we have a classification scheme. Within scheme, we are again forming the array. So when the collateral classes are there, then we are forming the array. So this is called array. Array, this is array 1, array 2, and array 3. So here you can understand the array. And if the this is called as a chain. Okay, so in classification, we are going into the depth of library classification scheme. So other things are also related with library classification, but we are going for the library classification scheme. Within library classification scheme, there are many array, means UDC, DDC, LC, CC, CON classification scheme. So this is called as a chain. So here the chain is created. So that is chain. And if it is the collateral class, means the same class having the same weightage, then it is called as a array. So this is array and this is chain, array. Okay, so each in every stage, this is array is created. And when array means any facet is going into the depth, then the chain will be created. So when we say that chain, then the depthness of the subject is more. And when we are saying that array, the broadness of the subject is more. So what happened in loose assemblage 3? The relation between DDC and UDC. So here the same array is there. You can see that this is DDC and DDC and UDC. So in between the array, we are forming the relation. And that is based on the loose assemblage 3. And that's why it is called as a loose assemblage 3. Okay. So loose assemblage 3, you might be understanding what is loose assemblage 3. Then the next one is fission. Fission means in this mode, an isolate or basic subject, be it main or non-main, gets fissioned or split into subdivision. Okay. So how it will be split into subdivision? It may be the main also, or it may be the non-main also, that will be get fissioned, or that will be split into the subdivision. For example, biology. So biology is the subject. Okay. So biology is the subject. And again, if we go further for the biology, then there is a different things. Means different branches, like botany, that when we study the plant, then it is called as a botany. And when we study the animal science, then it is called as a zoology. So here, this particular subject or this basic subject, okay, will get fissioned or split into subdivision. And we can take the another example also, like mathematics. So we have a algebra and we have a different mathematics, okay, means geometry is there. So we are splitting the subject, then this is called as a fission. Then the next one is dissection. So this term is used to denote fission when we consider an array of division of an isolate or a basic subject resulting from fission. So whatever we are getting from fission, then we are creating another dissection. So after this, doing the fission, we are cutting the entity into different section. Dissection is what? Dissection is cutting a universe of entity into different parts of coordinate status. Even as we cut a slice of a bread into different type of strips. So whenever we cut the particular subject, then we have a different type of lamina. That part is called, when we cut the subject, that part is called as a lamina. Here we are taking the example like botany, then agriculture, then zoology. So all are split of biology, but we consider them as an isolate subject because it will means it will develop so soon and tremendously it will develop. Then we are understanding that, we are identifying that this will be the main subject or this will be the isolate subject. Okay. So here botany, agriculture and zoology, we can take the example as a dissection. So in dissection, what we are doing? We are cutting the one subject into different section. So that meaning is very easy for all of you. So dissection means cutting the universe of subject into different entities. So that is called as a dissection. Then we have another mode, that is denudation. And this term is used to denote the fission when we consider one and only one of the subdivision of an isolate or of an basic subject resulting from the fission. Now you can see the example like philosophy, logic, deductive logic. So what happened in denudation? Denudation is the progressive decrease of the extension. So here, progressive decrease of the extension and increase of the intension. Okay, like array, we have seen the decreasing, increasing in the chain, increasing of the extension and decreasing. Like you can see here, once we this is the array, and once again, if this subject is divided into different thing, then these particular main class means subfacets is divided into again subfacet. This main subject is again divided into different subfacet. So here this is array, and this is when we are going into the depth, then the automatically increase the intension and decrease the extension. So here once you can see the example of philosophy, logic and deductive logic. So in philosophy, logic is coming. Once you once you study the logic, you are going into the depth based on the deductive logic. So you are in philosophy, philosophy will be the broad. Then within philosophy, if you are studying the logic, within logic, you are studying the deductive logic. So you are going into the depth of the subject. So that is called as a denudation. Okay. So in denudation, the increasing the extension, increasing the intention and the decreasing the extension. So that is called as a denudation. Then we have fusion. Okay, fusion. So we have seen the fission. Fission means we are one subject will be there and that will be the split into different two facets. So that is fission. F-I, that is fission. Now fusion in this mode, two or more main subject are fused in such a way that each of them loses its individuality, identity, and in respect to of the schedule of isolate needed to form the compound subject going with it. So you can see here the example, like biology plus chemistry. So biology is an individual entity, means biology is an individual subject. Chemistry is an individual subject, but when we mix it, all the characteristics of biology in the biochemistry, then chemistry in the biology, then it will fused, the subject will be fused. So here this is a reverse. Here one subject is there and we are splitting it in the fission, fission. Fission. Okay, but here what happened? Two subjects will be there, and then within two subjects we are creating a one subject. So biology, whatever the concept of biology or characteristics of biology we are using with the, or mixing with the chemistry, or concept of chemistry mixing with the biology, then the subject become the biochemistry. So after then biochemistry will develop like that, and it will create their own individual identity, and that it will form the compound subject also. So that is the fusion. So don't get confused in the fission and the fusion. Fission is one subject will be cutting, means one subject will be splitting, and here two subject will be coming together. So that's that is the basic difference between the fission and fusion. Okay, and then you can take the n number of example, like biochemistry. Biochemistry we have taken, like biophysics, astrophysics, astronomy plus physics. So like that, there you can take the different examples also. Then the distillation. Distillation in this mode of pure discipline is evolved as a main subject, and out of the experiences in appearance, in action, in diverse compound subject along with the most basic subject without host compound subject. So for example, management. In management is a general subject, but management is applied to every subject, okay, like management of library and information science, management of other discipline. So distillation in this mode of pure discipline will evolve as a main subject, and after that the concept of all the main subject will be used for the other subject. So management will be applied everywhere, in library science, in MBA, or in economics, or in different event management. So like this, in many areas the management concepts are applied. So that is called as a distillation. Then we have a agglomeration, and previously Dr. S.R. Ranganathan called as a partial comprehension. So here the several main subjects are sometimes treated integrally or disadjunctively in one and the same book. For example, we have the agglomeration. Agglomeration might have been a main subject in every early days before fusion advanced sufficiently. Okay. So for example, natural sciences, humanities, social sciences. So natural sciences is a combination of various subjects. Humanities is a combination of various subjects. Social science is a combination of various subjects. So that is called as a agglomeration. Okay. Then we have a subject bundle, that is cluster. In this mode, a new kind of partial comprehension of a subject is formed. And for the convenience of the organization of the research, various we can obtain the data from the different basic subject or the compound subject, and going with the different basic subject, the study of some of the phenomena will be published in one and the same book, and further investigation and elaboration will be developed the another subject. Okay, and this is the result of the cluster, and that is called as a subject bundle also, like ocean sciences, space sciences, defense sciences. So these are the, previously it was the branch of the geography. So geography, ocean sciences, space sciences, defense sciences, now they have created their own individual entity and they are knowing as an individual subject. So that is called as a subject bundle. Okay. So what we have seen, there are different type of modes and for what purpose these modes we have to study, because whenever a new specific subjects are developed, that should be given a specific place to the without disturbing the previous sequence of the subject. And that's why we have to study the modes of formation of subject. So we have seen the 12 modes of formation of subject. And thank you for joining this class.